boys.
Hello.
Hello.
It is so lovely to see you.
Nice to see you.
You've grown up before my very eyes.
It's been far too long.
There's only four of you now, but it's fine, because there's only three of Take That, and Take That are doing even better than ever. So you've not to worry about it.
Thank you.
I'm just letting you know that. I'm just letting you know that it's all going to be okay, and you've not to worry.
We've been worrying for the last 6 months.
And now,
thank God you've come along.
Where have you been?
We needed you 6 months ago.
Perfect. What an amazing title. What an amazing title, because you are.
I don't know about
that. Stop there.
Which is true.
Price on emotion, looking for something to buy.
Yes, this is one of the things in this fandom that we like don't talk about every day, so I love talking about it. So basically, Justin Bieber's album Purpose and Made in the AM were released on the same day in 2015 on November 13th, I think. And there was a bit of a promo war with it. So in this photo, Justin Bieber's holding a sign that says Purpose, but someone put Made in the AM over it and then put Made in the AM CDs like in front of the Purpose CDs. I'm sorry, this is just so funny. But to me, the icing on the fucking cake of it all. Someone commented my friend likes Justin Bieber and One Direction. I don't know which one to get him. Should I get Purpose or Made in the AM? Fucking Selena Gomez said Made in the AM. One of my favorite pointless stan wars, but obviously nothing atop the Twitter fight with The Wanted.
Life gets hard and it gets messed up when you give so much and it's not enough. The high's too high, the low's too low when you love someone and they let you go. Don't you let it kill you, even when it hurts like hell. Oh, whatever tears you apart, don't let it break your heart.
Oh my God!
Who is it that called wearing? Who is this lady standing in front of me? Yeah. Is this your auntie?
Are you really?
Sister?
Oh my God!
Sister.
Seriously?
No. Sister. Kind of stepmom.
Stepmom.
A very young one.
Wow. Okay. Well, you need to be back to your very attractive stepmom.
There's my favorite white boy!
It started with a whisper, and that was when I kissed her.
You're insecure.
We're here on the set of a commercial that we're doing for Toyota.
It's the first thing like this that we've done, an advert with a brand new car. It's exciting.
The setup for the ad today is that we are scrapping off the tour bus and the ones are turning up in the Vios, so we have a nice stylish ride in.
Louis is a good driver, Harry's good too. Liam's learning, I reckon he's going to be good because he's quite sensible. I reckon if we put us on a track, we'll do a good job in the Vios.
The boys have got to say things in English, then they've got to say things in Chinese. I've got no idea how the boys Chinese is.
Say sure in Chinese.
Here we go again.
Go babies, go babies. Something people don't understand. It's not about if you love a woman or a man. And when I heard these words, my life truly began. Cause that's the day I started accepting who I am. I tell myself to breathe now, but I want to scream now. I'm trying to make my family.
Yeah, Bella, it pains me to say, but it was absolutely brilliant song choice, actually. It was a brilliant song choice. I don't know if you've got anything to do with that or not. It was just a really composed performance. I think I had a kind of a similar feeling to Robbie in your first audition. It was very, very excitable, but it came across professional, composed, well done. And I loved your lyrics as well, well done.
Ready, Mull?
Yeah. Oh, the Tour Eiffel.
The pitiful look. Hey, Molly.
Fuck off.
You missed half the tour there.
Hey, Molly.
Yeah?
Do you want to go for a pint?
Yeah, I'll go for a pint. Don't let me talk to you. Don't let me talk to you. Take me far from with you. And I won't say, don't let me talk to you.
No time for goodbyes, didn't get to apologize. Pieces of the clock, the lies broken. If I could take us back, if I could just do that, and write in every empty space the words I love you in, replace it every time when I'd erase me. If you could.
America anymore, because what is the Avengers without Captain America? Can you turn this up, please? The song's playing. That couldn't be better. That is hilarious. No idea.
Leg out. I'm fucking sick of it. I'm fucking sick of it. I'm fucking sick of it. Oh.
A celebrity who just genuinely seems like a really nice person.
Story time. So I used to be a spotlight operator. Basically, I've worked for people like Justin Bieber, Ed Sheeran, Taylor Swift, Mariah Carey, and shone a huge ass light on them. But my first ever show was One Direction. I was freaking out. If I didn't shine a light correctly on those boys, I would have had hundreds of thousands of teenage girls hating on me. Pretty sure they did 2 or 3 shows in Perth. After the first show, I was sweating because I had such long hair and that light is just super, super hot. So I went and got a haircut. Harry Styles was backstage on the second day and I'd already seen him once, but you can't talk to them unless they talk to you. He looked at me very confused, as if he'd known me but didn't know me, kind of like this. We locked eyes. And he goes. It seems like such a small thing, but the fact that a huge celebrity noticed me whilst I was working felt really good compared to the other people I've worked with.
I ain't tried to forget you, but your mother thinks I'm the best for you. Try and try to raise you, but you won't disappear.
My favorite friendship or relationship dynamic ever in history is this. Individually, the two people, intelligent, they're so smart. They're just like very, like, they're practical, like they know what they're doing. They're geniuses, really. But when you put them together, it's like the intelligence cancels out. It's like a double negative, like in math, how things cancel out. That's what happens. And it's just they share like half a brain cell. And that brain cell is taking the day off. Like, it's, that's, oh my God, just perfect. It's fantastic.
Happy birthday, dear Lulu! Happy birthday to you!
As I said, let us back up dance on stage. What do you think?
Would you like to dance together or separately? You take this side. There is one rule that is the most important thing possible. If you even think about getting in my way, I'm dead.
No. I'm easy going. I'm easy going. Just don't get in my way.
Rebecca. We're going to sing a song now. This is the band. Hey, everyone, Hannah, Rebecca. All right, we're going to sing. Dance, do whatever you want. You don't have fun now, Rebecca. Oh, my keys. Alright, you don't have any shoes on. Yeah, I have no problems. Am I alright, girls? Am I alright? Give it a big gun, don't get in the way. Here we go.
Bar.
Real joy. Yeah, we had a gin bar because my father passed away when I was young, but I love gin. And so we all just had all these, and then Four Pillars, who are like the best Australian gin company, made me a, hold on, wait there. I'll be real quick. I'll show it to you.
Sick.
In my house, I can.
So there's Ash gone. She left me on her, on my own in her house. This is journalism at its finest, Australia. You are seeing it right here. Nice room, though. She obviously does the old Pilates and the yoga in there.
Yeah,
here she's back. She's back.
So,
what's she got?
The gin company Four Pillars made me my own bottle, and it's got Honey, my dog, on it.
Sick.
And it says Brian Family, because my husband's name's Adrian Brian.
That
is cool?
By the way, that is the most Australian name of all time. Brian. Adrian Brian. By the way, that is the most Australian name of all time. Brian. Adrian Brian.
I'm going to be honest now. I'm going to be honest and I'm going to get it out there. And I think you know what I'm going to say. There was a very definite time where you promised me that your firstborn would be named after me. You haven't called it the name that we all agree is the best name in the world, James. Can you tell everyone? Can you tell everyone what you've called your son and explain why it wasn't me and where your name came from?
Well, I mean, I can see I'm surrounded by Jameses.
Yes.
So you can't really be the first James anymore, can you? It's not possible. So the only logical thing to do was to call him Bear.
When he was born,
I think one of the midwives said it, and he had this thing where if they don't have a good cry, they get food in the lungs, which is quite serious. So he was like going away, and like when he was sleeping. So I had like specialists running in and out of hospital all day. My missus was asleep. And he was like being checked over. They were like, oh, we're not really sure. We'll get somebody else. And I had like 10 doctors come in the room. And then the guy was just like, dude, I'm not being funny. There's nothing wrong with him. He just likes to make a lot of noise. And that's carried on ever since. So it just became Beth.
It's Christmas time. There's no need to be afraid. Here's to you.
Raise a glass to everyone.
Okay.
Hey. I think I'm touching Miles first.
No, he is.
I think James is the best. He's better than the rest. He's never made it look so easy. I think I'm touching Niall's ass. I think we're gonna fart. And Harry's hair is always greasy.
Look, it's a whole Harry Styles in a good trouser thing combo. I mean, that's not filming. There we go.
You're my honey bun, sugar plum, pumpkin. You're my sweetie pie. You're my cupcake gumdrop, snickums, bickums. You're the apple of my eye. And I love you so, and I want you to know that I'll always be right here.
You know, Joe won it because he was one of the friendliest contestants out.
We're the friendliest contestants here as well.
So, if anybody hasn't seen the show so far, who are you and what are you singing and all the rest of it?
One Direction, if that's all we're saying.
Fair enough. Well, I've forgotten what fun it can be doing this.
That is great. Right. Right. What, on the road?
Yeah.
Like
so what's your names guys anyway?
I'm Louis.
Louis.
Niall.
Just a reminder, these two picks were only 3 months apart.
What, are they on the wrong way around? I have as well. I got my phone case on the wrong way around.
Me, I'm had it. They're flip cam, they want to say hello to you.
What? Hello.
She did a picture, guys.
It's like 1,000 degrees outside, so you have to listen to my air conditioner, I'm sorry. But we have a lot to unpack today, thanks to Liam.
First up, Liam and Maya split, which is really sad because they were really cute together, but she was very problematic, so... But I'm not going to get into that. He did an interview, and he talked a lot about a One Direction reunion, stating, "I'd rather be talked about it sooner rather than later. It's tough touring that sort of a record, but none of us talk about it." He also said, "It's like a taboo subject, like we can't get back together? Like, what do you mean? Like, oh my god, us in the same room, what the fuck is that about?" It's upsetting that it's like a touchy subject, but it's comforting to know again that he wants it. He also says he talks to Louis a lot, and they've always had a really close connection, which is adorable, but we knew that. But about a reunion, he doesn't understand really why that they can't talk about it. I think if there were to be a reunion, it wouldn't be for a long time. After HS3 probably, and NH3 and LT2 and LP2. He continues to give me hope.
What's this bitch crying about?
Seriously, no. No armpit farts, no nothing. No deal. Alright, and then we'll you be back. You can fart from your armpit. Harry, obviously, where you've been locked away for too long.
I'm sorry.
Seriously, what's wrong with you? You
One Direction Songs with a Deep Meaning, Part 3. Hey Angel is about fans who have passed away. Harry was reported say that this song was about fans who have passed. The lyrics are pretty self-explanatory. Hey Angel, do you know the reason why we look up to the sky at? This song is close to Harry tweeting about it for times before the release. When Liam first heard the lyrics, he said it left him in tears.
Feel like that at all. We felt like, you know, as we felt like we kind of deserved a little, maybe, you know, a year off or just something to chill and see our friends and see our family.
I want to go and just write some music. I think Tomo is going to join in with me on that.
I will play now, yeah.
You know, we're all very much looking forward to seeing family and spending some time that we've missed. And, you know, going to the studio and writing songs doesn't feel like, oh, you know, it's, I have to go do that again. It's like, it's a fun thing and it's a creative process, and I think the nice thing about the break is you'll just be writing, and it won't be from any other place apart from that you want to write songs.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away.
I've been holding on to hope that you'll come back when you can find some peace. Every word that I've heard spoken since you left feels like a hollow street.
What happened to you?
I lost my best friend.
Two kids, you and me. And I say,
I figured out how to think about you without it ripping my heart out.